Well, welcome again, folks, to the Truth Guitar Channel. Gary Hudson here from Folkstone Guitars. And today we're going to be leveling and beveling these jumbo stainless steel frets. Last video on this same neck, we were showing what is involved with placing just one fret on a bound fingerboard. Now we've got it all taped up. And so let's start the leveling and the beveling and let the good times roll. First thing we're going to do is take just a regular steel file, and we're going to use this to get the bulk of the edge off these frets for the beveling. This gets them down fast. And I usually just use my thumb sort of as a guide for how much of a radius I want, or how much of an angle I want, rather, on the edge of the frets. Now we're going to come over this with the diamond fret file. This is a Dia Sharp extra coarse diamond fret leveling file. We're going to finish those edges off with this. It's a nice beveled edge on those frets. It's going to work out just great. Like this, it gives you a little better angle. Shows you better what's going on. Now I'm going to take the coarse file. I'm going to work on this with the coarse file for a while. Smoother, get some of that rough cut off of there. It's a nice beveled edge that's developing. See that? See that? Look at all that steel, man. That bevel edge. See that? And that's how we do it. It's a lot of work. We're going to level them after this. I just wanted you to get a view of how I make the bevel. All right. Get it screwed into the table. Knock all that fret dust off of there. Screw it back into the table the other way. There we go. Now, I hope you're digging that Eric Johnson there in the background. I'm digging it, you know? See, Gary, I don't like that sound. That makes me cringe. It's just like, you know, somebody dragging a piece of chalk over a chalkboard. Well, yeah, some people. To me, I love the sound of it. I just like the sound of work. Yeah, baby. Looking really good. I know you really can't see what I'm looking at, but man, this thing is beveling nice. I used to have to bolt these to a block, and I had a block with an angle on it, and it had a flat side that rested on the frets, a piece of wood, and it had an angled side about 30 degrees for the side that I would have for this beveling. But I got to where I could just use my thumb to guide along and do it by hand, and it works out just fine. All right, let's go for the coarse diamond leveling file with this fine on it. And it's beveled up really nicely. Here we go. All right. Now for the leveling. Again, we'll start with the extra coarse diamond fret leveling file. These are really nice, great tools. These pieces here are not cheap, these files, but they do the job. Stuff you gotta have to do steel fret. Little steel files you can't really use on these for leveling. Now we're leveling. Let's take them down pretty good. Especially if you see a fret wire that's not being touched. If it has no scratches on it, then you know that the frets before it and after it probably need to go down further. You need to really get it so that all the frets have a little bit of a fret file marking on them. Then you know you're getting to the level point. Squaring up those edges. A lot of people want to know what this guitar is going to do. I can't wait. I'm not even going to do the headstock on this one. I'm just going to leave it monoprice, just like it is. It'd be more defiant that way anyway, don't you think? And keep going with the radius. Alright. Lots of fret dust. Do we have them level? Only one way to tell. My trusty fret leveling. It's called a neck check. And Stuart McDonald sells these, but you can get them a lot cheaper on eBay actually. and they're great. It's a nice four-sided object for the different spacings of the fret wire to check the level on it. Start off with a long spacing, and then just check the level. Fret rocker, that's what it's called, fret rocker. Those are level. Check it from one end to the other. If this thing rocks, then you don't have a, you don't have them level. It rocks at any point. All right. Those are level. So far, so good. Well, that's good news. We don't have to worry about the first 10 frets here. It looks like they're all level. It's great. Right where they need to be. Now we're going to go to the next smaller end on this. Because you do 3 frets across, of course. Looks like it's level. Those are going along pretty good here. That's a nice fingerboard. And I gotta tell you, man, I've had Gibsons and Fenders that weren't this level at all at this point. I mean, I was really having to take a lot of material off some of the frets to get them level because the fingerboards were just so dang uneven. But this thing here, this thing's got a very even fingerboard. I've never had a Gibson fingerboard, that I've refretted that was this level with just this much material taken off the frets in an initial leveling. Never had a fingerboard this level from a Gibson. That should tell you something about what they're doing up there in Nashville. And voila, the entire fingerboard is level. Got it right the first time. That hardly ever happens. Man, the thing was right the first time. Can you believe that? I don't believe that.
Wow.
You know, to start with, I've got a steel recrowning file. It's a little wore out, but it still works pretty well. And I'm going to go ahead and use it first because these are a lot cheaper, and I'm going to get the bulk of the crowning going and some of the jagged edge off the edges with this. It's going to spare my diamond recrowning file. These are like about $30-$35. This crowning file costs it costs $112.48 from Stuart McDonald. Don't ask me what the 48 cents is for. I don't know. But anyway, here is the steel recrowning file we're going to start with, right on fret number one, and you take it until you see the groove begin to diminish. Of course, this leaves some file markings that you want to use the diamond recrowning file for ultimately. Plus, I've noticed that the fret wire gets really hot. And it gets to where you can't even touch it using the steel file. But you gotta round these frets up, and here's why. The intonated point of a fret is the center. In other words, where that tang is, right in the dead center of that fret wire underneath, is exactly where the intonated point is. So therefore, you want to have a rounded top on the fret wire so that when you fret the guitar, you're not going over a flat bobby pin type of a fret wire, but you're going over a rounded top, which means that your string is going to rest dead center for best intonation. That's another thing bad about nickel frets. check your nickel frets. If you've been playing a lot of rock and blues and string bending, the steel strings will just wipe the tops just flat, just like these. It'll look just like this after a while. Even though you might not have that deep of divots down here or ruts in the frets, you might think, oh, my fret job's okay. The ruts aren't all that deep. But actually, what you're doing is you're flattening the crowns. You're putting a flat space over the top of your crown that is destroying your intonation. Which is good about steel frets because they won't ever do that. They retain their intonation. So now we've got the diamond recrowning file. And we're going to go ahead and go to work with this. This will take the scratches out, the roughness that was done by the steel recrowning file, and it'll smooth it out. This is a 300 grit, which is my favorite, and it'll finish the crowning as well. Didn't quite crown them all the way with the other one. That's a nice, nice crown. Gosh, I just can't get the camera up here close enough right now for you to see, but these things are really looking beautiful. Just beautiful. Really look good once we get them polished. Continuing on with this diamond recrowning file. There's a little line that's left right on the top of the fret from the leveling file, and when that line becomes invisible, you can see it getting smaller and smaller and smaller as you're recrowning. When that line becomes invisible, that fret is done. You don't want to take any more than that off at that point. Alright, about got them leveled up here. I'm checking them to see if there's any of those lines left. If there's a line on it, then that's an area that's still a little flat and not quite rounded up. So we'll make sure we got them all rounded up 100%. All right, next we're going to check the level again. Have to do that after a recrowning. Don't trust that you did a perfect recrowning. Only trust the fret rocker. And so far so good. We'll see how this comes out. So far so good. Alright, we've made it halfway up the fingerboard without any problems. Yeah, it's looking good. Looking really good. That's great. There just needs a little more. A little more rounding there. There it goes. That did it. Alright. Level up real easy. And there we go. Okay, my frets are now leveled, beveled, and recrowned. Next, we take the fret end dressing file, and this is one of my favorite little things to use, and come in on these edges, and we round them up. This not only beautifies the ends of the frets, but it also gets rid of any little burr that's on there. So any burr that is left at all on these frets is taken off with that. And somewhere along the way, I'll see one that's not quite rounded up like it needs to be, like I just saw those. Let me go ahead and hit those again. And keep checking as we go. As the fret dressing file causes you to look a little more carefully at the frets, so you'll catch something you missed, perhaps. Now I want to check the level on those that I just did. Make sure I didn't throw anything off. And it looks like nothing was thrown off. Everything is still right on course. Good. Continuing. And I love this thing because it's got a rounded edge that you use down on the fingerboard. Then it's got a squared off edge that's sharper. But you can use that rounded edge down and you won't do any damage to the fingerboard or leave any tool markings or anything. This is a really great tool, also from Stuart MacDonald. See if I can show you what's going on here. The fret end, it's got little burrs like, it has to be filed off. And that's how we do it. The polishing and the sandpaper, steel wool alone won't do it. Of course, you don't use steel wool on these because steel wool on stainless steel frets will just cancel out. It really won't do anything. So you use some sandpaper and some metal polish, which I'll be showing you. I've gotten down to the polishing of the frets. I've got them all dressed and the crown ends are rounded up nicely. Everything's beveled good. It's looking really cool. I'm going to take one of my sandpaper bends here, a piece of 400, and we're going to start with that, and we're going to go lengthways this way. Be sure to get the edges well in this. Next thing we're going to do is take 320. You're probably wondering why I'm using 320 now to go the other direction. It's because it gets the scratches off quicker. That's the 400 left. So just take 320 and go the opposite direction this way. Don't press very hard, just a little bit, just enough to get those fine scratches off there. And that usually does it. Then we're going to go with 600. 600 across this way. Again, go this way. Right. And I like to take the 600 again and go this way. 600 again and go this way. This is how you get frets to shine, folks. This is how you get steel frets to really, really shine pretty. Now we're going to go with 1500 sandpaper. This way. This way again. And with 1500, I'm bearing down a little bit. I can afford to do that. And a fresh piece, 1500. This way again. Now we're going to go this way again. One more time, this will complete the sanding. And it's shining really nicely right now, but they're not done. They're looking really good right now. But what I'm about to do to them really does the trick. Really makes them shine. This is my Maz metal polish. This is really some great stuff. M-A-A-S. And it's for polishing all metals. There's a lot of great metal polishes out there. It's just this one I prefer. Come with a nice tube. Yeah, just tear me off some pieces of paper towel. I like using these Viva paper towels. They are nice and soft. And there's no printing in them. Just plain. Take me a little bit of metal polish and polish the frets. Boy, does this really shine them up. You see what comes off the fret wire? It's just black stuff. Steel, black steel comes off of there as you're doing it. You might notice some movement with this neck as I'm working with it. It's bolted down, but I don't have it really bolted tight to this because I like keeping the neck flat. And if I bolt it down, it has a tendency to bow up a little bit. And I like keeping it flat as possible as I'm doing the work. So that's the reason for that. You can see this black stuff just comes right off of them. And this really shines them up. I mean, they really look pretty when you get back with them. Stuff. And sometimes I use it, depending on how it's looking, I use two applications on a single fret wire, just making sure that it is getting thoroughly polished. I'm always careful to keep my polishing rag here on a fresh place. Turning it. And when I get them all polished and all waxed up, then I'm going to come back and I'm going to have to wipe them off and do the last bit of polishing as I wipe the the excess paste off of them. This stuff is great, man. I mean, it just beautifies these things. It's gorgeous. And they tend to stay this way. They tend to stay really polished nicely. It's beautiful. Actually, this polish is pretty powerful stuff. You can see there's some excess scratches that are left, just some little hair scratches maybe in the fret wire that are left. This pretty much takes care of them, gets rid of them as it polishes the fret up. So it's really better to use this steel wool. Polishes them up nicely. Now, of course, with nickel frets, I don't use this metal polish. I use steel wool because the steel wool will cut into the nickel fret and it polishes it for you. If you use quadruple-aught steel wool on nickel fret wire, it polishes them as good as they can be done. And really, the metal polish doesn't do anything for nickel fret wire that you can't do with quadruple-aught stainless steel wool. Here we go. Tear off a few more patches. All right, things are really looking great here. Real happy with the fret job that I did. Now what we do is just a little bit of final dressing. Any place I can feel just a little bit of a burr that the tape did not allow me to get to. There are a few places that the tape was in the way and just didn't allow me to get the burr off. It's just a little bit some places. You gotta dress that off. So you take your trusty little fret end dressing file and you get rid of those little burrs that are left. Alright, now it's time to beautify it a little bit more. To do that, I use the Gurlitz fingerboard oil. It's called Guitar Honey. This, you can use this on anything on the guitar. It's just great stuff. You know, we just go ahead and just put it right on there. Helps preserve the fingerboard, gets any of the sticky left from the tape, gets it off. It's great stuff. Works its way into the wood, and preserves it. And we do this on a setup, by the way. You bring your guitar in here to be set up, and we'll fingerboard oil it for you as part of the setup. So, here we have the neck, and there is something else that has to be done. Some of that adhesive got on there, and we got to get rid of that. Shines up real pretty. Let me get the camera in over here and see if we can get a close-up of this so you can really see what this fret job looks like. Can you see that? How does that look? Oh yeah, man. Oh yeah, baby. Oh yeah. Oh yeah, she's gonna play just, oh, feels so nice. Absolutely. Absolutely. That's a player. And you just wait, my friend. This thing gets strung up and players begin to play it and make some demos for me. You're going to see some satisfied people. And these guitars are going to play just fantastic with these stainless steel frets. All right, that's it. Completes the fret job on the Monoprice Pro Audio Series. The Route 66 guitar, which is available for $139 at the monoprice.com website.